Hey guys,
right.
How's it going?
Tough setup, but we got it done.
Yeah,
nice angles.
The first camera there, you could tell, is in the attic. You can see the ball. Camera two, the second floor of the barn. Third camera is a basement hallway. Four there is the hallway in the second floor where they claim to have seen apparitions.
Of the little girl. Just be careful. Don't know what we're up against in this place. So we're set to go?
Yeah, man.
Let's go, lights out.
Jane Grant, Prospect Place, attic. Hey, you know what, Jay? Let's deliberately place this red ball right now. All right.
If you're up here, we'd like to play ball with you. Can you move a little rubber ball?
Just tap it.
Grant and I were trying to make some sort of contact with a child entity who has a tendency to play with the ball.
Maybe you're trapped here for some reason and you want to get out.
Or if what's up here is just too much of a coward.
Makes you wonder if it appears as a little child, because some of the reports sound a little bit intense.
It appears as a child because that's how it sees itself. Or appears as a child to try to gain our trust.
Exactly. Come up to us, scream in our face.
Kick us.
Slap us.
Footsteps right in front of us.
Did you hear that?
Yeah.
It was right here to my right.
How was it? We started getting what sounded like footsteps. I heard something that sounded like a little thump, thump, thump.
We're fascinated by your amazing display. If you can affect the wood on the floor, you make a footstep, you can move the ball.
So we tried for quite a while to make contact, to no avail. But why don't we take the stuff, head out of here for a few? All right, we're gonna leave now.
Let's start out in the hallway.
Okay.
Yeah, here it is, that window. This door, actually. Supposedly, a young girl fell from her death right here, all the way down. But supposedly, she's seen here, and she's seen over here, and she's seen over here as well.
Cool.
I have the EMF gauge. Let's start out in the hallway and just get some EMF readings. Let's see, 0.2. 0.1.
EMF stands for electromagnetic field. We look for electromagnetic fluctuations. We believe that paranormal phenomena manipulates and distorts that energy, and we use EMF gauges to find and report that fluctuation.
What's that? Is anybody in here with us? Let's do some EVP work.
All right.
If you are a little girl, we're here just to be your friend. We're here just to talk to you.
EVP stands for electronic voice phenomena, a sound or voice that imprints on a recording device, in this case, a digital recorder.
Can you come to me? Can you come to Dave? Can you say hello?
Oh, locked door.
Daughter's bedroom?
No way.
I'm thinking the barn is where we can raise some real hay.
Or negative four.
No, it's less than negative four.
Yeah, I know. Grant and I headed to the barn area. It's brutally cold outside.
My jeans, I think, are freezing right now.
Look, hang on, something was just...
Stop that.
We'll rewind for a sec. I want to stay right on this thing. Second floor window. Something black was just sitting up there.
What the frig?
Grant and I headed to the barn area. It's brutally cold outside. The temperature is somewhere in between -4 to -10. Look, hang on. Second floor window. Something black was just sitting up there.
What the frig?
I don't know if it's an animal or what. There appeared to be something standing in the second floor window of the barn. At one point, it actually appeared that it was standing off as if it was watching us.
So Grant and I went to the barn to see if it was an animal or another person.
All right, dude, it was that window right there, right? Is that you, friggin' bounty hunter man? There were no animals or people in there. So we're gonna send Steve and Tango in there to see if they can make contact.
Wow.
Thank God I wore long johns, man.
All right, Tango.
Now, all in here is where the apparition of this guy is seen mostly.
It's creepy up here, man.
Yeah. Want me to start EVP?
Yeah.
Tango and Steve, barn, second floor.
Now, I understand you were a bounty hunter. Is that true? Does that have anything to do with why you were hanged? We can't even imagine facing such a gruesome death. And we really do feel for your turmoil, but hiding in the shadows isn't going to help anything.
Please come towards us. Show yourself. Say hello.
You need to come choke us, push us, whatever it is you do.
Maybe he knows it's cold as heck.
And maybe he knows we won't last.
Yeah, I was thinking that
maybe
too.
Maybe he knows, hey, you know what, it's cold, and come 20 minutes from now, these guys don't want to get out of here, you know what I mean? Like, he may just be hiding out knowing that, you know, we're not going to last 2 hours out of here. Right now, we just think that if you were murdered here, that there's a good reason for it, and we probably would have done the same.
When I'm not getting a lot of activity in a place that I think could be active, I try a different approach. I try provoking.
Maybe you were a coward.
I'll use harsh language. I'll become demanding in hopes that this riles up the spirits. It has worked for me in the past.
This provoking thing isn't working. Let's get back inside.